This inclination demonstrator is a useful prop for talking about our perspective when viewing extrasolar planetary systems and how the vantage point affects which systems we can detect. Note that it consists solely of a large yellow ball representing the central star and a small black ball representing the extrasolar planet. They are mounted on a plexiglass sheet representing the orbital plane of the planet. There are a number of things that are important to keep in mind when using the apparatus. Note that both the star and the planet orbit in the same plane. Both objects orbit their common center of mass, and you need to use your imagination to picture them in orbital motion. This demo, like many demos used to teach astronomy, is not to proper scale. The planet is likely much smaller, and the common center of mass much closer to the star, maybe even inside it. Keep in mind that we typically can't see the planet. We are inferring its existence from the effects that it has on the star. What astronomers can detect with different methods depends very much upon the angle at which we are viewing the system plane, known as inclination. Detection also depends on other quantities, such as the luminosity of the star, size of the planet, the star-planet separation, and the astronomical equipment used. Note that we view other solar systems with all possible inclinations. This demonstration will focus exclusively on how inclination affects detection. We will define inclination as an angle between 0 degrees and 90 degrees. When the extrasolar planet plane is viewed face on, we refer to the system as having an inclination of 0. So face on equals 0 degrees. While if the extrasolar planet plane is viewed edge on, we refer to the system as having an inclination of 90 degrees. So edge on equals 90 degrees. Let's talk about the major methods of extrasolar planet detection. The transit method has identified a very large number of extrasolar planets because it is the method used by the Kepler space probe. In this method, the planet actually cuts in front of the star once per orbit. So the existence of the planet is inferred from the periodic dimming of the star. Does this method work for systems at an inclination of 0 degrees? No, it doesn't. The planet does not pass in front of the star when seen from this vantage point. Does this method work for systems at an inclination of 90 degrees? Definitely yes. Does the inclination have to be exactly 90 degrees? No, but the range of inclinations where you still get a transit is quite small. Let's start at 90 degrees and slowly decrease the inclination. Note the value when the planet just barely still eclipses or appears to touch the star. So the value of inclination must be pretty close to 90 degrees and depends on the size of the star, the size of the planet, and their separation. But for many transiting systems, it is something like a 1 degree range, between 89 degrees and 90 degrees. So only a small percentage of extrasolar planets in existence can be detected by the transit method. Let's turn to the radial velocity method. The existence of the planet is now inferred by the periodic fluctuation in the radial velocity of the star, which is detected by Doppler shifts in the spectral lines of the star's spectra. So the star alternately moves toward you and away from you. Can extrasolar planets be detected by the radial velocity method when their orbits are face-on at an inclination equal to 0 degrees? No. The separation between you and the star does not change periodically as the star orbits the center of mass. Can extrasolar planets be detected by radial velocity methods when their orbits are edge-on at an inclination equal to 90 degrees? Yes, the separation between you and the star definitely changes as the star orbits the center of mass. Radial velocity is just like the transit method in that it works the best when viewing systems edge-on. Do minor deviations from 90 degrees affect your ability to detect extrasolar planets by radial velocity methods? Let's slowly decrease the inclination and picture the motion of the star about the center of mass. Note that the component of velocity toward and away from you gets smaller as you move away from 90 degrees, making the planet more difficult to detect. But as long as the inclination is not 0 degrees, you still have some chance. But it certainly is more likely at inclinations closer to 90 degrees. Let's apply this knowledge. Imagine that you wish to learn whether a star might have a planet, and if it does, you have no idea of what the inclination would be. Based solely on inclination considerations, your best chance of observing a planet's existence would be by what detection method? Your instructor will now stop the video, allowing you to make a prediction. Make sure that you explain your reasoning for making the choice that you did. Transits only occur for a very small range of inclinations near 90 degrees. Radial velocity works best near 90 degrees, and as long as the inclination is not 0 degrees, there is some component of velocity along your line of sight. We can see this in the following graphic showing an extrasolar planet at inclinations of 90 degrees and 87 degrees. Note that for an inclination of 90 degrees, either the transit method or the radial velocity method could be used. However, for the 87 degree inclination, a transit no longer occurs, though there is still a large radial velocity. That will still be true for many smaller values of inclination. So how do our two methods support each other? If you detect a planet with one method, can the other be used to confirm the planet's existence? So if you detect the existence of a planet by the transit method, can you use the radial velocity method to confirm the detection? Yes, because although radial velocity works best for inclinations near 90 degrees, it does work well over a large range of values. If you detect the existence of a planet by the radial velocity method, can you use the transit method to confirm its detection? Not likely. In fact, so infrequently that the best answer is no. Transits can only be detected for a very small range of systems for inclinations very near 90 degrees. Many more systems are detectable by radial velocity methods. More teaching materials are available on the web at astro.unl.edu.